Hello everyone, this is Manisha Girolkar from Dr. Kalmadi Shamrao High School, Pune. Our school is one of the first schools in Pune to start computational thinking curriculum by CS Pathshala. We are 6 computer teachers and we have allotted 2 periods per week for CT activities. Along with teaching computers, I am engaged with my students working on innovative projects in our Atal Tinkering Lab. That is how I came across the concept of design thinking and physical computing. So today I am presenting a modification in design thinking process in physical computing. In my presentation, I will be sharing my experiences and why I felt the need of variation and what is the impact of that variation on students' learning. So let me start with physical computing. The physical computing refers to interacting with actual physical devices in the real world controlled by programming. We are surrounded by such devices like right from washing machine to AC to even pacemaker to self-driven car. Some of the projects listed here done by our students in our ATL like noise controller, bus robot or smart garbage bins. So the question is how we make them enable to work on such projects or such systems. So as per the guidelines of Atal Innovation Mission, we follow the design thinking approach. Design thinking actually gives you scope to think laterally. Children get opportunity to think critically. They get out of the box ideas. It leads to innovation and strategic business thinking also. So let me quickly go through the 5 steps of design thinking. Empathize, define, ideate, prototype, and testing. So what is mean by empathize? It means you have to understand the problem. Children have to go to the community and interview the people, talk to the people, and understand the problem. Like I told you that children have designed noise controller. It is not because we gave them that topic to design such a device. It is because they identified the problem of increasing noise level in school. And they come up with the idea and they design that device. So after empathize, there comes define step. So in this stage, the most important thing is articulate your problem. Writing down the problem statement clearly is very important to keep them focused. Then comes the step of ideation. So here children come up with different ideas. The rule is no idea is bad idea. And actually here the innovation takes place. And when a basket of ideas is ready, children pick up one of the best idea they feel and using prototyping tools available, they design the prototype. Then comes the testing. So in testing phase, again, they have to go to the user and check whether their solution is as per their expectations or not. If not, they have to again redefine the problem, again put up some ideas, and maybe they have to redesign the prototype. So this is very useful approach. Lots of learning happens in the process, but still at one stage I felt the need of variation. For that I would like to share my experience with you. So in the Smart School Hackathon, students were given some of the problems, some of the challenges, and for that they have to find out the solutions. So one of the teams have selected the problem of missing book alarm. So while packing school bags, children sometimes forget the book and then they face the problem. So the problem statement was very clearly stated and children come up with different ideas. So they are listed here and then they chose one of the idea, that is using color sensor, they can display the message and they will design a gadget like a watch which will display the message about missing books. So they gave the name as book swatch, and they told me that this will keep watch on your books. That's why the name book swatch. Okay, so on the day of hackathon, they use plasmo color sensors and they develop an app in MIT App Inventor, and they successfully send a message on the mobile phone. So in between, they drop the idea of creating entirely new gadget. It's better to use readily available mobile to send the message, and it was really successful completion of their project. So after this competition, as they have made very good progress on this idea, I wanted to have them involved in building it further or use it for other projects. Not only this team, but other teams have also worked a lot. So I discussed with them, and I asked them, what is the next plan? So they said, okay, we will work. And everyone went back to the step one. They started thinking about new project, new problem areas, new problem statements, and ideas to solve those problems. But using previous idea, which was evolved through their efforts, can be used for the new problem, was not at all in their minds. And here, I felt the need of variation, a need to review the process. So as you know, design thinking is iterative process. Here you have to jump to any step at any given moment till you get the perfect solution. But in schools like ours, where many children are working on different projects, it is not necessary that every prototype will get converted into product. But we have to keep children encouraged. And sometimes it is also observed that because of repetitive tasks, they get bored. So as a facilitator or as a teacher, can we abstract the model of problem solving which they have followed to complete one project and go to the core idea of that problem solving? And even though the problem is solved by that specific idea, let us check, it has the potential to solve many other problems. And yes, many a times this happens. See, that BookSwatch app has the potential to solve whole inventory management system or stock checking problem. So here I would like to suggest, just focus on the idea or the process in design thinking cycle for specific solution, and then generalize it for multiple solutions. So here I am putting my idea, abstraction of an idea in the challenge-based project and generalizing it for implementation of on multiple problems. When we say no idea is the bad idea, we should also see that the best idea has the potential to solve multiple problems. When I discuss with my children with this new perspective, they really come up with a series of problem statements which looked possible to solve with the model which they have already developed. Like this BookSwatch app girls said, that we can keep track on grandparents' medicine when the parents are not at home. And we can set this device with the caretaker when we don't get trained nurse. We can help the blind person to detect color codes. And as we have also discussed, the color codes can be replaced by barcodes, and the model can be used for school library. And now for every project, we just go through the process and we try to find out the structure of the problem solving process. So here the impact on my students are, students have learned the process of problem solving because we are reviewing it one more time. They learned abstraction and generalization. They realized the potential of their idea, and that increased their confidence. They could present the structure of whole problem solving process as a function, where the Changing parameter will give you new output. They are able to think laterally and critically to solve many problems by dissolving the boundary of a specific problem and its solution. In a conclusion, I would like to say that to keep our student encouraged, these proposed variation would be useful for all the teachers working on tinkering activities and innovative projects. Our main objective is to take students beyond making prototype, presenting it, or winning the competition. We have to make them real problem solver, innovators, and thinkers. So here I really thankful to Dr. Paritosh Pandya. With his valuable guidance, I could complete this presentation. I am thankful to CS Pathshala, my students, teacher colleagues, and Principal Ma'am.